गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, दिस इज आस मोहम्मद खान एंड आई वेलकम यू इन टूडेज सेगमेंट। इन आवर प्रीवियस सेगमेंट स्टूडेंट वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द सोल्यूशन एंड द कम्पोनेंट ऑफ द सोल्यूशन। सो देर आर द टू टाइप ऑफ कम्पोनेंट्स ऑफ द सोल्यूशन, फर्स्ट इज सोल्यूट, सेकेंड इज सोलवेंट। एंड अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ सोल्यूशन वी हैव ऑल्सो डिस्कस दैट देर आर द थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ सोल्यूशन अकॉर्डिंग टू द स्टेट, सॉलिड सोल्यूशन, लिक्विड सोल्यूशन एंड गैसियस सोल्यूशन। टूडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द कंसनट्रेशन ऑफ सोल्यूशन। नाउ वट इज कंसनट्रेशन? कंसनट्रेशन मीन्स स्टूडेंट द अमाउंट ऑफ सोल्यूट इन द सोलवेंट, मीन्स वी गेट द कंसनट्रेशन विद द हेल्प ऑफ सोल्यूट एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू द कंसनट्रेशन वी कैटेगराइज द सोल्यूशन इन टू टू टाइप्स, सैचुरेटेड एंड अनसैचुरेटेड। सैचुरेटेड सोल्यूशन हैव ऑलवेज हाई कंसनट्रेशन बिकॉज इट कंटेन्स द मोर अमाउंट ऑफ सोल्यूट स्टूडेंट, बट अनसैचुरेटेड सोल्यूशन हैव द लेस अमाउंट ऑफ सोल्यूट देन इफ वी कंपेयर इट विद द सोलवेंट, एंड इट इज नोन एज अनसैचुरेटेड। So there are the two solutions, saturated and unsaturated. Like if we discuss about the honey is an example of saturated solution. Cough syrups are the examples of saturated solution. Or we can say the soup is an example of saturated solution. And unsaturated solution, salt solution student, or sugar solution, if the salt and sugar is found in the less amount in the particular solvent, then we can say that solution is unsaturated. If there is more concentration, like in the case of the sweets, some sweets like the rasgullas and gulab jamuns, they are dipped inside the sugar solution, and that sugar solution have the high concentration student, or we can say them that they are the saturated solutions. So sweet juice that is used with the sweets, that are the examples of saturated solution. Now we come on the concentration of solution, that how do we get the concentration of the solution. So there is another one formula student from which we get the concentration of the solution. Now what is it? Concentration of the solution, this CONC is for concentration student. Concentration of the solution is amount of solute upon amount of solvent or amount of solution student. So one thing you can write here, amount of solution or amount of solvent you will write, is that the quantity that is given in the question, and the same formula you can use in that. Now amount of solute means we can say that the amount of solute is directly proportional to the concentration of the solution. What does it mean? It is directly proportional, because if we increase the amount of solute student, then the concentration will be also increased. If we decrease the amount of solute, then the concentration of solution is also decreased. So we can say that the concentration of the solution is directly proportional to amount of solute student. And what example I gave to you about the solute in the case of sugar solution and salt solution. In sugar solution, what is solute? Sugar. In the salt solution, what is solute? Salt. In the tincture iodine solution, what is the solute? Tincture iodine. Now, it is means the concentration of the solution is inversely proportional to amount of solution or amount of solvent student. Means when we increase the amount of solution or solvent, when we increase the amount of solute and solvent, then the concentration is decreased. Why? Because it is inversely proportional. If we decrease the amount of solution or solvent, then if we decrease, then the concentration is increased. So these are the factors on which the concentration of solution depends. First factor, amount of solute. Second factor, amount of solution or solvent. So these are the factors on which the concentration of the solution depends. Now, how do we get mass by mass percentage of solution? Mass by mass percentage of the solution. Mass by mass percentage of the solution we get with the help of one formula, student. And in that formula, what will you write? You will write mass of solute upon mass of solution into 100, student. Means the percentage you get with the help of multiplying with 100, na? So the same formula you will use. First, what will you write? You will write the mass of solute upon mass of solution or volume of solution, student. If you are, so both you can take mass of solution. According to the question, you can take the quantity, mass or volume. So this is the formula, student. Now we will discuss some question related to this. Now we will solve this question, student, in this. A solution contains 40 gram of sugar in 360 gram of water. Calculate the mass by mass percentage of solution. This is the question. Now in this, what is given? Mass of solute is given. Mass of solute, that you will write. What is it? So solute, or in this, in bracket we will write sugar. And what is it? It is 40 gram. Mass of water is also given in this, student. Mass of water. Or we can write this mass of solvent, because water is considered as solvent, student. So mass of solvent is, it is water. What is it? It is 360 gram. Now, with the help of this, we can get the mass of solution. So what will you write? Mass of solution. For getting the mass of solution, you will add them, solute and solvent. 40 plus 360. So what answer you will get? It is 400 gram. So this you will do. Now what is asked? Mass by mass percentage is asked. Mass by mass percentage of solution is asked. Now what is the formula of this? Mass of solute upon mass of solution, that we have got mass of solution into, we are getting the percentage, so into we will write 100. 100 we will write. Now we will put all these given quantities in this and we will get the answer. Like, what is mass of solute here, student? What is mass of solute here? It is 40. So you write here 40. What is mass of solution we have got here? It is 400. You write here 400 into 100 according to the formula, into 100. Now from these two zero, these two zero will be cut, and from this 4, this 40 will be cut, and the answer that you will get here, it is 10. So what is the answer in this? It is 10%. So 10% is the answer of this question. Means when a solution of contain 40 gram of sugar in 360 gram of water, calculate mass by mass percentage of solution. So what answer you will get in this? In this, it is the 10%. So in this way, you will get the percentage, student. Mass by mass percentage you will get. So thank you very much and have a pleasant day.